So, welcome back to Cessna Home Cockpit. Today is a flight in Belgium. We are at Oostende Airport, Oostendebrugge Airport, called EBOS. And I've downloaded some scenery for it, free web scenery. And we're just trying to fly and to do a flight across the Belgium coast, up to 4XP scenery. And I have also visited the site apxp.info. It's a great site. On this site you can find a lot of information regarding the airfields, airports in X-plane, and they have information regarding the frequencies, radios, runways, etc. So it's great for planning the flight. But first, let's fire her up. Master switch on. Prime the engine, oil pump on, fuel pump on, I mean, and fuel pump off. So resetting my trim wheel. See, the flaps are down. I modified my autopilot panel from the SciTech, and now the flap switch doesn't work all the time, so I'll have to try to find out if I can get the flaps up. Ah, there they go. Flaps up. Engine temperature, oil temperature is still not right, so we'll have to wait. Well, I'll change the frequency. COM 1. Ground is 118.17, so that's 118.17. And ground is 121.90. 121.90. Okay. Well, let's try to taxi. Let's see if we can make a sharp turn to the left, because there is somebody standing in front of the plane. Parking brake off. Oostende a couple of times in real life. It's a nice city. It's located near the coast, Belgian coast, which is nice for a short holiday, especially if you have young kids. They have go-karts and they have all kinds of entertainment. For instance, Plopsaland. It's about all famous Dutch and Belgium characters for kids. They really love that. Let's see the runway. I will do just a short flight. And last video I told you I also had an Oculus Rift, and I used that a lot last week. And I must say it's a really, really great experience, virtual flights. Although this is also very good. Yeah, I got a lot of reactions on my last video. I told that I didn't know what I preferred, which is better, the home cockpit or the virtual version from X-Plane. And I'm still not sure what I miss in the virtual virtual reality is it's not as detailed as this cockpit. I mean, it's not you don't see the details. You can't see the runways as sharp as now, and resolution is a lot less than in the 2D as this cockpit. So that's why I like this a lot. Also, you can't use any paper. I have checklists. I have written down some information about the airport, and in virtual reality that's not possible, although I know Laminar is working on that to create such a possibility. That would be great. I also have a butt kicker installed in my chair, my race chair, and when I use virtual reality and I use the butt kicker, it feels so realistic. You actually feel every bump on the runway. You feel when you are landing. It's yeah, it's just amazing. So let's turn the plane. So I have to get used to, let's see how the temperature is. I have to get used to flying without virtual reality, but I still like my home cockpit. I also got a question from a viewer about how I created the bezels from the Gorgeous. Well, actually those are, I don't know if you have that everywhere in the world, but it's called Pringles. Pringles are some kind of potato chips, and they are in a box with a and on top of the box there is a plastic circle, and that's I use for the Gorgeous. I painted it black with a text marker, and it looks great. I also have a 3D printer, and I'm experimenting with that, and that makes it possible to print my own parts for the cockpit. I'm trying to print in a better radio stack. It doesn't work at the moment, but yeah, to say it's a nice it's a nice hobby, and it's nice to be able to print your own stuff. Well, we are here at the coast line, Belgium coast. I'll make a turn, I'll go to the north. What I also did was change the roads in Auto 4XP so they don't stick out as much as they did in the beginning. Now looks more realistic. Make a very sharp turn. Oh yeah. I'll fly to the north, direction of the Netherlands. Over the sea, it's the North Sea, so that you can see some scenery. When I fly south, you don't see anything, I think, because I'm blocking the window, the left window. So there's the airport scenery, which was a quick flight. I was planning to fly to Rotterdam or Zeeland, but it takes too long, and I don't think people are interested in watching movies which take longer than about 20 minutes. So that's why I always do short flights. If there are people interested in longer flights, please let me know and I'll do longer flights, but for now the short flights are okay. Well, if you I don't know if you can see the scenery and the roads, but they look much better. They're not as dark as they used to be. Only the bridges are sticking out a little bit, and that's something I have to try to find out. My frame rates are actually pretty good. Let's see, at the moment I have 37 frames per second, so I can increase the detail. And but I like a fluid motion over detail. So I think 30 frames per second are the least I should have. See, this is Oostende at the right. It has a harbor, small harbor, not the biggest one, but it's I think one of the biggest harbors in Europe is Rotterdam, followed by Antwerpen, which is pretty close to Oostende. I think about 70 miles, and perhaps I'll do another flight Oostende. As you can see, right, there are a lot of bungalow parks, people who are visiting holidays at the Belgian coast, and in front of us is a place called De Haan. The French people call it Le Coq sur Mer. It's a nice, nice little village behind the dunes, and we'll make a turn at De Haan. I will try to fly back to Oostende and land. About the cockpit, I'm still thinking about rebuilding the radio stack. I don't like SciTech equipment because it gives a lot of problems. Drivers are not recognized. For some reason, sometimes USB doesn't work. So I'm trying to find a way to create better radios. It's not easy because it's expensive, but I have some ideas by using an old iPad and then attaching real buttons so it looks real, and that should be great. Well, here at the right of me is a place called De Haan, as I told you. And we'll make a turn to the right, go back to the south, and we'll land again at the Oostende. So it's a short video, I think, but it's nice to be flying again in the home cockpit. Also had a question from a viewer who wants to visit me. Lives in the neighborhood, I think, of near Aachen. It's about 50 kilometers from where I live, so perhaps we'll meet and we can change some experience. It would be great. So if you're watching, I'll contact you as soon as possible. airport in front of us. I saw some videos on YouTube from other people who are building the cockpit. One of the tricks I use in my cockpit, like to share them, is to use to make it not look like if you're in a box. I use round edges, so my the walls of my cockpit are not vertical; they are rounded off. The roof is not straight; it's also a little bit round. So by adding some curves in the cockpit, it makes it look realistic. Also, my air vents and top left and top right are add to the sphere. They are not realistic, but they make it look a little bit more real. What also works is using the right scale of the equipment. So I have a panel which has the actual dimensions of the real Cessna cockpit. So my gauges are exactly the same size as the wheel. My GPS unit is the same size, it's about 16 centimeters wide, and that's the original dimension. But as you can see, my Cytec is too big, Cytec equipment. So I'll, that's why I'll want to replace it. Reduce the power. Starting to land. Approach. This is something which is very easy to do in the cockpit, because I can see the runway in front of me there. In virtual reality, this is very difficult, because the resolution isn't as big. The resolution is actually much bigger, but because you are with your eyes very close to the screens, it looks like you're watching through some kind of vents. So the Cytec Joke is very difficult. I have the Cessna Joke, as I told in one of my videos before. That's much better than the ProFly Joke, because it can rotate 90 degrees to the left and to the right. That's the real joke, so you have more control. I also modified it, I replaced the pods, so it has a better response, but still it's not great. I'm wondering if I'm thinking about buying a Flight Illusion Joke, but that's... I think 1400 euros, so that's a lot of money. I have a discount from 10%, but still that's a lot of money, and I can't afford it, so I'll have to wait. And I'm thinking about rebuilding my Cessna yoke and attaching it to the Leo Bodnar panel, which gives a more precise control and reduces the dead zone. See if we can make a good landing. A little bit slow. wobbling is because of the satellite joke. In VR you have much more control of the plane. So the rudder is very twisty. So that's a pity. But we're back at Oostende where we started some minutes ago.